These are flower Legos. They didn't come ready-made like this. They are made up of dozens of pieces. Each one consists of pieces in total. Around pieces were used in flower pots. The remaining pieces are in the flowers. Each of them is a copy of a flower in nature. This is anthurium. We call it the flamingo flower. The pot consists of pieces. The flower itself consists of pieces. This is the original. This is a replica made of plastic. Dye is added as each piece is produced. They are cast into special molds. Why are special molds needed when producing these? I want to make a flamingo flower painting here. First, I draw a sketch in pencil. I'm painting this green. I stop just when I reach the edge. Why am I stopping? Because that's the shape of the leaf. I need to paint according to the shape of the leaf. I paint green here and red here. If I pour the paint here randomly, it will not take the shape of the flower. Dye molecules are not smart. It doesn't see the sketch. I need to spread the paint in a controlled manner. There is water in that jug. The water has taken the shape of the jug. I pour water into the glass. The water I pour takes the shape of the glass. If I don't use this mold and pour it directly into the tray, it will spread. It is not under any control, because the water molecules at the edge do not communicate with each other. Iron molds stop the molten plastic when it reaches the edges. That plastic model consisted of 50 separate parts. The original flamingo flower consists of different tissues. Parenchyma cells, collenchyma cells, sclerenchyma cells, xylem, phloem, epidermis, root cells, stomatal cells, meristematic. These are cell types, but the number of cells is much higher. There are more than 10 billion cells in such a 40-centimeter flower. In other words, it consists of 10 billion non-plastic organic Lego particles. Everything starts with a single cell. It germinates from a seed and grows. It undergoes metamorphosis step by step and acquires a different structure. Tens of billions of cells are created from nothing, and as if they were communicating, take color and rush to their places from the plans in the seed. No cell extends beyond its boundary. A plant undergoes metamorphosis step by step and acquires a different structure. Are there any such products that humans make? Something that transforms step by step and gains a different structure? The answer is this.
It is a process in nature where plants metamorphose step by step and acquire a different structure. It is known that such processes are imitated by humans, or that there are products that similarly undergo step-by-step metamorphosis. Here are some examples.
The examples given are origami, 3D printing, modular furniture, and Lego. Origami is an art of paper folding. Flowers like this are made. ...3D printing needs a machine like this. It is not a spontaneous formation. It's human-made. Modular furniture is like this. It is not grown from scratch, but the opening of sections and changing shapes. Lego is already built by human hands. In all of the above examples, there is human intervention at every stage. There is no transformation or metamorphosis without the touch of human hands. What I mean is growth and change, metamorphosis, step by step. The Eiffel Tower consists of 18,038 parts. These parts are connected with a total of 2.5 million rivets. Let's lay the foundation of its plan and let it rise slowly. I asked again, there is a human factor in what you listed. How does this transformation occur in plants? ChatGPT takes its explanations from biology books. So it is natural for it to be like this. Environmental factors made it so, by mechanisms. If there is a reasonable change in development, there must be a reason for it. Here's documentary filmmaker Louis Schwartzberg. He has dozens of awards. He makes time-lapse documentaries. Documentaries hot for hours and days, but sped up. He has a talk at TED. He questions this topic in his talk, the hidden beauty of pollination.
I've been filming time-lapse flowers 24 hours a day, 7 days a week for over 35 years. To watch them move is a dance I'm never going to get tired of. It fills me with wonder and it opens my heart. What motivated me to film their behavior was something that I asked my scientific advisors. What motivates the pollinators? Well, their answer was, it's all about risk and reward. And like a wide-eyed kid, I'd say, why is that? And they say, well, because they want to survive. And I go, why?
Yes, why? Why should flowers grow from the soil? Why and for what reason did these flowers, each a separate work of art, appear on Earth? We do everything we do for a reason. According to botanical science, there are 5 basic hormones that enable 10 billion S of cells to be built from a tiny nucleus. Auxin, cytokinin, gibberellin, ethylene, and abscisic acid, all produced from the same material. Hydrogen, oxygen, and carbon are common to all. There is also nitrogen in auxin and cytokinin. 5 different hormones are created from the same atoms, but with different bond patterns. The functions of the hormones are as follows.
Auxin organizes the elongation of plant cells and regulates the growth of roots and shoots. It helps heal the plant's wounds. It regulates the plant's reactions to light and gravity and determines the direction of growth. Cytokinin enables cell division and growth. It delays the aging of leaves, regulates female flower production. It increases resistance to extreme temperatures and diseases. Gibberellin is responsible for seed germination, shoot growth, and flowering. Ethylene accelerates fruit ripening and subsequent leaf shedding. It regulates the thickness of the stem. Abscisic acid. If the seed is not planted in the soil, it closes the air intake holes of the seed to reduce water loss, stops germination, and reduces water use in drought.
Organizes, regulates, helps heal. Regulates, determines, enables, delays, regulates, increases, responsible, accelerates, it regulates, closes, reduces. Can these words describe mindless and unconscious molecules? Which workers in a Lego factory correspond to the hormones that enable plants to grow? Auxin's counterpart is designers and engineers. These employees plan and organize how products will grow and develop. Gibberellin's equivalent is production supervisors. It ensures that work accelerates and progresses efficiently on the production line. Cytokinin's counterpart at the Lego factory is personnel managers and instructors. They enable employees to work efficiently and increase their competencies. They renew the workforce. Abscisic acid is the equivalent of the Lego factory, quality control and crisis management experts. They manage problems that arise during the production process and ensure that products comply with established standards. Ethylene logistics and distribution managers. They organize the preparation of products at the right time and delivery to customers. But are there conscious officers in unconscious plants?
No, plants do not have conscious officials. There is no consciousness in plants. These hormones work through biochemical and biophysical processes. They perform their functions unconsciously.
It is said that they carry out their functions unconsciously. They have no consciousness, but they achieve what 21st century technology cannot. This is the plastic raw material. It consists of 3 monomers: acrylonitrile, butadiene, styrene. It is melted in machines and poured into molds. No one would believe me if I said that these plastic flowers formed by themselves from this plastic raw material. What if I put it in boiling water? What if this boiling lasted a billion years or a trillion years? If it boils forever. If I give electricity, if lightning flashes, this is what will happen on its own. unless a wise hand intervenes, a single Lego cannot be created. This is man's greatest contradiction. He says that these dead, lifeless flowers need a designer, a factory, an engineer, that they will never happen on their own. But when you ask who created the thousands of living flowers in nature, he can say that nature did it. Unconscious hormones caused this growth. However, everything is very clear. Look at the power of God, five unconscious molecules to produce thousands of different types of flowers, as if they were all separate factories.